Hello and welcome back to Proactive. I'm delighted to be joined here in our London studio by Scott McKenzie, who is a fund manager with Amati Global Investors, focusing on small and medium cap companies. Scott, great to have you here.
Thank you very much. Great to be here.
It's a pleasure. Thanks for making the journey in. And I'd like to start by asking for a little bit of background on the situation with small and medium cap enterprises, because it's been a bit of a rough year, hasn't it?
It has indeed, Tom. That's an understatement. It's been a very difficult year for small cap investors. The main indices are down well north of 20% in the UK. So one of the most difficult years we've had for quite some time, probably since the global financial crisis. And you know, compared to larger cap companies, the FTSE 100, you know, we've fared pretty badly in the current year.
That's right. I think a lot of people have been struggling, haven't they?
Indeed. Yeah.
But you put out quite an interesting video not too long ago in which you gave five reasons why you believe that the tide may be changing in 2023. So would you like to just run us through those bullish factors?
Sure. I mean, what we were trying to identify in the recent analysis is, you know, looking at some of the problems that small cap investors have faced in the current year and say, well, will these things actually change as we go into 2023? There have been a lot of macroeconomic issues this year in particular. So the first thing on our list was interest rates. You know, and clearly, you know, the cold quarting, trusting, you know, led to something of a panic with regard to interest rates. You know, I'm pleased to say that's now begun to die down somewhat. And we're kind of taking the view that the interest rate bad news is largely in the price. And we don't really expect the base rates to go much beyond 4% from where they are today at 3%. So we think the panic about interest rates is largely in the market already, and hopefully that's something that, you know, people will begin to feel a little bit more comfortable with. The other big macro factor has also been sterling, and particularly against the dollar in the current year. The pound has been weak now for a number of years, particularly since the Brexit vote in 2016. And again, if we look back at the quarting trust, kind of debacle, if you can call it that, you know, that really marked the low point for the currency. I think we got to almost 105 on the sterling dollar. And as we sit here today, we're now at 120. So that's begun to improve quite a bit as well. So those are two kind of big macro factors that, you know, have certainly been difficult for small cap investors. We've also seen a lot of redemptions of UK funds in the current year. And again, that's not a new trend that's been happening really for the past 5 years. You know, people have allocated away from UK shares in general into more global portfolios. But that has really, we believe, reached a crescendo in the current year. You know, there have been particularly large outflows from UK equities, and we don't really think that's something which will continue much longer. It's already, you know, taken a fair bit out of the market. And then the two kind of final things that we would focus on particularly are the valuation of smaller companies and also the potential for takeovers within the UK stock market. So the valuations, you know, smaller companies have been hit pretty hard in the current year, and they now look, you know, quite attractive, particularly compared to larger companies, say in the FTSE 100. And as a result, we are expecting to see more takeover activity. And we've seen a bit of takeover activity in our fund already this year. So those are, you know, some of the things we think may not get any worse, and hopefully will get better.
Fantastic. Now, I suppose from your point of view, this must look like something like the bottom of the market, which would mean that now is really the time to be investing in small and medium cap enterprises.
That's broadly what we believe. I don't think we would claim to have the skills or the foresight to time the bottom exactly. That's an incredibly difficult thing to do. But you know, when we look back in history, the probability of small cap asset class having two very poor years in a row is relatively limited. We had, you know, a particularly bad year during the global financial crisis, and then bounced back fairly rapidly after that. So you know, we do believe there's a lot in the price. Some of the factors I've just outlined we can't control. You know, we're giving a view on interest rates and currency, but the fact is, you know, we don't really know. The same with the redemptions. We can't, you know, predict how, if those will end. But I think with regard to company valuations and the attractiveness of UK small company shares, you know, we do believe we're getting close to, you know, a very attractive entry point.
Mm-hmm. So do you think there are any sectors in particular that you think might lead the charge into 23?
Our approach is to have a very broadly based sector profile within our core funds. So I wouldn't particularly highlight any specific sector, But I think one of the things we probably would highlight is that the smaller company sector tends to have more exposure to the UK economy than say the FTSE 100, which is predominantly, you know, non-UK. So some of the sectors which have been impacted by concerns about interest rates and inflation and recession, you know, some of those, you know, have got scope to bounce back. You know, so for example, real estate is a sector that we think looks quite attractive, you know, having been sold off fairly heavily in the current year. But at the other end of the spectrum, we also see areas such as technology as being quite attractive. Obviously, a number of tech firms have come a cropper in the past 12 months. NASDAQ is down materially as well. So, you know, if we do our homework, we can find ideas in a variety of sectors.
Lovely. Well, just finally, Scott, is there anything that you'd like to say directly to our audience of investors?
I think our main message at this point is that let's not be too gloomy. It's been a difficult year. We all know the recessionary headwinds that we're facing. The next 6 months, the news will not be good for the economy, and a lot of people will find things pretty difficult, and some of our companies will find things pretty difficult. But our view, you know, as longer-term investors, is to try and look beyond, you know, the short-term headlines, and that's what we're attempting to do with some of this analysis. You know, and we very much focus on what the next 3 to 5 years will bring rather than, you know, the next 3 to 5 weeks. So keeping a long-term perspective, I think, is really key at this moment in time.
Understood. Well, Scott, it was a pleasure to have you in, and thank you very much for joining us on Proactive.
Thank you.